this short video, I'm going to be showing you how you can make pretty much any element on your page sticky, which means it's going to follow the user as they scroll down your page. Here are some more examples. So it can be pretty much any element that you can imagine that you need to be sticky on your page. So it can be a subscription form, it can be contact form, it can be an image, it can be simply a regular sidebar, as you see here. To make it possible, all you need is the plugin called JetTricks, which is an add-on for Elementor. You can get it if you follow the link in the description under this video. And it does a lot of great things. And it allows you to add some complex and really great looking animations on your pages created with Elementor, and it also is extremely fast, so it won't slow down your pages in any way. So let me get back to the Elementor editor, and right here you see that I've got two columns, and one of them goes outside of its box. So you see there are the boundaries of this column, and you see that it simply goes outside and follows the user as they scroll down the page. So it's pretty simple to pull off. So what you need to do is to make sure that the element you want to be sticky is in its separate column. So this is actually not the element that we're making sticky, but the column itself. So it's more like a sticky column thing. And whatever you put in this column is going to be, it's going to become sticky as well. So I'm going to delete this sidebar and say, I'm going to drop an image in this column and select whatever. And you see that as I scroll, it also follows me down the page. Now, how do you actually create this sticky column? How do you make it? How do you make it sticky? So it's pretty simple and it needs a couple of clicks actually. So what you do here is you create one more column. If you didn't have one, you simply click a duplicate column and it automatically creates the duplicate of the column that you already have, and it places it usually on the right of the already existing column, and all you need is to delete that widget. Now you simply make it as wide as you need it to be, like so. I guess that looks okay. And then you go and search for the element that you want to put in there, that you want to be sticky. Let's go with the sidebar example again, just for the example purposes, to showcase how this theme works. So that's pretty much it. You have set up your look that you want to go after. And what you do now is you click on the edit column button. And now you're in the edit column menu, and you go to advanced, then you scroll down and you find the JetTricks tab, which actually appears once you install JetTricks plugin. And you simply click sticky column option and it makes it sticky right away. If you want some more specific settings, here they go, their top spacing, which only determines how much space you've got at the top of your element that is inside the column. Basically, it's something similar to setting up the top margin, right? It looks pretty much the same way. So you simply set how much space there is between the top of the page and the beginning of the first element right there in the column. And the same goes for the bottom spacing. Also, you can choose on what devices you want this function to work on, desktop or tablet devices. Maybe you also want it to work on mobile devices, or you want to disable it on tablets. That's completely up to you. So now you know how to make pretty much any element sticky with the help of Elementor Page Builder and Jet Elements plugin that you can get if you follow the link in the description under this video. The theme I was using for today's tutorial is called Monstroid2, which is a modular Elementor WordPress theme that goes with a ton of the coolest features. So if you want to check this out, you can also find the link to it in the description. So I hope this tutorial was helpful. Thank you for watching.